We have some grammar for you.
Hi, Sailata and Harika.
Hello, ma'am.
How are you?
Fine, ma'am.
Good, good. So, ready to learn something today?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Did you have your breakfast?
Yes, ma'am.
What did you have, Harika?
Idli
with?
Chutney.
Chutney. Okay. You had idli with chutney. So, you had idli and chutney. Good, good. What do you have usually, Sailata?
I usually have idli or chapati and chapati.
Okay, idli or chapati for breakfast. We South Indians have variety of food items for breakfast, right? Usually in Western countries and all, they have bread and butter or bread and butter or jam, right? Or they have just coffee with some biscuits, cookies. So like they have normal breakfast. But we have variety of breakfast. Good. Did you attend the last?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. After going home, what did you do?
After the class, we going to home.
You went home and had lunch. Good. What about you, Sailata?
I went to home by in a market in a bus stop. We buy some vegetables, ma'am.
Okay, you waited in the bus stop.
Yes, ma'am.
To buy some vegetables. After buying the vegetables?
Buying vegetables and going to...
You went home.
Yes,
right?
Ma'am.
So you stopped at the bus stop and bought some vegetables.
Yes, ma'am.
You stopped there and bought some
and
vegetables.
Bought some vegetables.
Right, okay. Did you buy the provisions also?
No, ma'am. Only vegetables.
Oh, you didn't buy provisions, but you bought vegetables. Okay. Right. In your sentences... We came across very common words. Harika told me, I have idli and chutney. Okay, Sailata said, sometimes I have idli and chutney or chapati with curry. Right, see? So, you use this word are and you both use the word this one. And when I asked you, did you buy provisions also along with vegetables, you said no. Then you said you bought only vegetables but not provisions. So, but. So, these we call as conjunctions. Right. The word itself says you conjunction means it's in the middle. So, it combines. A conjunction combines, now see, it combines two words or two sentences. Sometimes they also combine two phrases. In earlier classes, you learnt different parts of speech, like in that adverbs, adjectives, clauses, phrases, sentences, etc. So, two words you know. For example, Ram and Rahim are good friends. Right? Here, Ram and Rahim, you combining two persons. That's why we used and here. And here one word and this is another word. So here it is combining two words. And it is telling the same meaning, summing up. So and speaks about summing up. The ideas are adding similar ideas. Okay, similar ideas. When they combine, went home and took rest. Look at this. Here, Ram went home is one sentence and he took rest is another sentence. So, this and is combining two sentences. Right? And so as but and or. Now, let us see with but. It's Harika. but not Lata, who came late. Right, it's Harika, but not Lata. That means who came late? Harika or Lata? Harika. So the one who came late is Harika, but not Lata. So here also they are combining the words. Right. Then in another sentence, he is poor, but he is honest. So a good old saying says that if a person is poor, that he is not honest, people think, but it is not correct. So in contrast to that, so but expresses the contrast in meaning or difference in meaning. So and speaks about similar ideas, but speaks about contrast or difference. So here it just differentiate two words, and here it differentiate two sentences. Means it two different sentences are combined, right? So if without but, there these two are different sentences, right? So then when you use are, I eat, I take idli or chapati, means you are showing a choice. So or speaks about choice or alternative. What is an alternative here? Means this or that. So choice is shown. Then you say that right. Goes home or stays in hostel every evening. So either he goes home or stays in hostel. Stays in hostel. So here we are showing the choice of his. Then Ramani or Subha will be here with us tomorrow. So here also either Ramani or Subha. So here also we are showing the choice and alternative. Okay, here the alternative and choice, and but or. These three are called primary conjunctions because they can combine two words, two phrases or two sentences. But in the place of and only, we can also use besides. Right, besides also is combining two similar ideas or two similar sentences. So besides, in addition to, let's see, in addition to, here also we are mentioning the word addition, and moreover. Thus there are some more conjunctions, but they cannot combine two words, they can combine only two sentences, right? When we write a sentence with besides learning English, we are learning the Veena and classical dance. Means in addition to English, you are learning the Veena and classical dance. Means these also. So that is the meaning of this besides. But this besides can combine only two sentences. Here, this besides word always is misunderstood. I mean, it is, there is a confusion between this beside and besides. See, this beside is a preposition. Of course, besides also is used as a preposition and as well as conjunction. But beside means only by the side of, whereas besides means in addition to. So we have in the place of and, we have besides, in addition to, and moreover. Right? So we can make sentences with these also with the same meaning of. Right. Now let us look into this but. See, as you have already learnt, but speaks about contrast. When we say, I will go out, or I will stay back. This we use for choice, right? I will go home and watch watch a show on TV. Then I will go home and watch TV. So here, similar ideas. Here, choice.
Choice, sir.
Supposing you say, I'll go home, but I don't watch TV. Means you're going home, but instead of watching TV, you're doing something else. So, but. So this but explains the contrast, whereas the other two explain the some other. Then in this contrast, when it combines two words and two sentences, how it is used, we have seen already. So these sentences are, as I said, they came on time. But didn't attend the class. So there is some other reason for them to not to attend the class. So they came on time. Usually when they came on time, when you come on time, what do we expect?
Attend the class.
When you come on time, we expect that you attend the class. But something happened, you didn't attend the class. So that difference is shown, that contrast is shown here with the but. So in the place of but, we also use yet, though, although, even though, like this. So as in the earlier example, and can combine two words, two phrases and two sentences, but also combines two words, two phrases and two sentences. Whereas yet, though, although, even though can combine only two sentences. Right? In this, you can write although in the beginning too. Although he has money, right? He refuses to help others. He is rich. So, people expect that he can help others, but he doesn't. So, here in the place of adding but in the middle, we are showing it with although. Although he has money, he refuses to help others. So whenever, generally, whenever you ask, he is not willing to help others. Similarly, I was not well, yet I took part in the program. See. I was not well, yet I took part in the program. As I was not well, people expected me to take rest. but I didn't take rest. So instead, I took part in the program. Right? So this also speaks about contrast. So contrast of ideas or difference in ideas. These two are told by conjunctions. Right? These ones. They come under conjunctions only. Right? And the other name for these is linkers also. Because they link. They link two words or
two sentences.
Good. Or two phrases also. Phrases. Two parts of the sentence also. Right. Now let's move on to R. When we are dealing with R, what does it speak about? Choice or alternative? You see, when you go to parties, what do you think? You just stand in front of your wardrobe. See, what do I wear? This or that? Right? If I wear this, what accessories do I go for? So, this or that? So, always it's a dilemma. Right? So, that choice or alternative or that confusion we express with R. Right? Right. She goes to office by bus or in an auto. She has option. Either she goes by bus or in an auto. Right? So this R. Choice, we say. Right? This R also can be used with either or neither nor. So as a combination, we use this R. Okay, this can be used like that. So when it is used like that, we say this. Either this team or that one, right, is going to win. There are 7 teams participating in a tournament. You think that there are 2 teams which can come for final and which also in one of them wins. Usually one of them only wins. So in this case, either this team or that one is going to win. Look at this, there are 2, but we are using a singular verb because either or shows choice. So in that choice, only one you are choosing. That is the reason we are going with only singular verb. When neither nor also, see for example, when you say this team or that team, they both belong to single category, right? Third person singular. So when we combine the pronouns, the same category, either two singulars you combine, two singulars of different persons, or one singular, two singulars of different same person, same like personal pronouns, or you combine one singular, third person singular with third person plurals. Neither the coach nor the players. So here look at this. Neither the coach singular nor the players plural. But both belong to third person singular only. Right? When they are there, neither the coach nor the players, the coach singular occupies the first person, first position, and plural occupies the second position. Then the verb goes with R. Okay? Neither the coach, plural verb. Neither the coach nor the players were invited to the press meet. Right, were. Look at this. This is plural. Okay. So this is plural and were invited. Here we have to use a plural one because the first one is singular,
singular and second one is plural.
Verb agrees with the nearest one. right? But here also we go with the choice. Okay, thus with this or, these are ones, alternatives and choice it is shown. And we have any doubts in this?
No ma'am, no.
Clear? Right, good. So in this, there are some more conjunctions which speak about reason, result, like that. For example, because, right, as, since, for, these are some which we use for reason. For example, you say, I came late because I missed the bus. As I forgot the bus pass, I had to take the ticket. Since he is not well, right? Since he is not well, he is taking rest, like that. So this since and for, you learnt in adverbs also. But they are different, these are different. Words are same, but their usage is different, their places. And we have so, therefore, that's why. These we use for result. Okay. And if, unless, provided, supposing, these all we use for condition. If you work hard, right. If you work hard, yes, Harika, you will succeed. Excellent. Right, you will succeed. Right, I got wet, so I caught cold. Right, like this. You have the conjunctions. See, there are some typical conjunctions which we use with before, after. So time, for time also we used it. When we used it for time, they are adverbs. When we use them here as conjunctions, he came before I left the place. Right? Before. I went to the station.
Condition.
Yes, before also is conjunction when it is combining two sentences. Before 10 o'clock, then it is an adverb. Before I left, that is a conjunction. So like when, while, what, as, all these are all these conjunctions only. And supposing a book is a book, although there is nothing in it. A book is a book, although there is nothing in it. So such sentences you can make with conjunctions. Let me introduce you three conjunctions. So, until you know their usage, you don't feel them like conjunctions. Because in normal, lower levels of grammar classes, you don't find them. For example, you say, scarcely had the match started. When it began to rain. Right. Scarcely had the match started when it began to rain. That means the moment. Okay. The match did not even start fast. The moment it started, it rained. No sooner. Just write down. No sooner did I switch on the TV. Than the power went off. So no sooner is a combination with than, scarcely is a combination with when. So thus combinations of conjunctions you can. So try to collect some more sentences like this. Right? Thank you.